Good morning students, welcome to online class, class 10. We are already familiar with the poem How to Tell Wild Animals. The first part we completed in the last class. Today we are going to see the meaning the poet explained in the last two stanzas. Though to distinguish beasts of prey, a novice might nonplus, the crocodile you always may tell from the hyena thus. Hyenas come with merry smiles, but if they weep, they are crocodiles. So, the poet continues to introduce the wild animals. In this stanza, the poet introduces to the readers the hyena and crocodiles. Both the animals are beasts of prey. That means they hunt hunt animals and eat them. So here you see when you see a hyena or a crocodile, the novice beginners, those who do not know much about animals may be confused. While catching the prey, the hyena laughs. Hyena is also known as the laughing animals, and the crocodile is just opposite. The crocodile will be seen as weeping. When it swallows the prey also, it might be weeping. So there is some sayings about this these behavior of the hyena and the beast. Hyena commonly found as if they are laughing, and crocodile is found as if they are crying. Tears will be flowing from its eyes. So if you find an animal laughing, then you recognize it as a hyena. And if you find an animal as weeping, then you recognize it as crocodile. That's what the poet tells us. Thus, the poet gives us the identity of a hyena and a crocodile. Some words meaning: distinguish means differentiate, separate from. Beast of prey, any animals that hunts another animals for food. Novice, someone who new to a job. Nonplus, be confused. So beginners are confused to identify a hyena or a crocodile, because one is found as laughing when they catch the prey, and another one is found weeping when it catches its prey. Now let us see the literary devices used in this stanza. The rhyme scheme is same as the above stanzas, AB, AB, CC. Then another literary device used is alliteration, use of consonant sound N at the beginning of two consecutive words, novice, nonplus. Both the words begin with the consonant sound N. And also another alliteration is the beginning a word with TH, the, thus. Both the word begins with the TH. Then enjambment is used, that is a sentence continues to the second line or the next consecutive lines without a punctuation mark. So poet gives the examples, though to distinguish beast of prey, a novice might nonplus. Then another one, the crocodile, you always may tell from the hyena thus. So these two are examples of enjambment in this stanza. Now, the last stanza, the true chameleon is small, a lizard sort of thing. He hasn't any ears at all and not a single wing. If there is nothing on the tree, 'tis the chameleon you see. So in the last stanza, the poet introduces to us a chameleon, a small animal organism compared to the other animals already introduced to us. So the poet says, the true chameleon is small, a lizard sort of thing. He hasn't any ears at all, not a single wing. If there is nothing on the tree, it is the chameleon you see. So the poet explains to us the identity of a chameleon. It is, if it is a true chameleon, it is small. It is not in large size. It's small, like that of a lizard. He hasn't any ears at all, and the chameleon has no ears, and not a single wing, and the chameleon also has no wings. Chameleon has no ears, no wings, and if you find nothing on a tree, then you can imagine there is a chameleon on the tree. Why the poet has said, if there is nothing on a tree, you can, on the trunk of a tree or the branches of a tree, then you can imagine that there is a chameleon. Because chameleon are said to change their color according to the color of the place where the chameleon sits. So according to the color of the place where the chameleon sits, the chameleon changes its body color also to that. So that is a quality given to chameleon to escape from or save itself from the attack of its enemies. Because the color of the chameleon and the place where it sits is the same. So other animals cannot identify a chameleon so easily. So that is a quality given by the nature to chameleon to save itself from enemies. So finally the poet gave us the identity of a chameleon. It looks like a lizard. It has no ears and no wings. And if you find anything if you don't find anything on a tree, then you can be sure that there is a chameleon. The literary devices used here. First, rhyme. The rhyme scheme is same as the above stanzas, AB, AB, CC. Then alliteration is used again in this stanza also. The word begins with H sound. He hasn't. Both the word he and hasn't begins with a consonant sound H. Then consonant is used. A consonant sound is used in the in different words in the same line. Use of G is done here. Single wing, single and wing. G is used in both the sentence. So consonants is also used in this sentence as a in this stanza as a literary device. So I hope you understood the poem. Thank you everyone. We shall meet in another class with another topic. Thank you again.